Hello, everybody. It's the Kazan here, finally back after a month. Yeah, I took a little break for a month just because there wasn't much to upload. I'm hoping some of the newer games that are coming out this year I'll be able to upload. I also saw the Spyro Trilogy. I'm like, yes, something I can fucking record! I really loved Spyro as a kid. I mean, yeah, I could be doing the Crash Trilogy, but... those games aren't as fun to me. Platforming ain't my best games. And also, I would have done a playthrough on this game, but at the very end of the boss fight, as soon as I accepted the quest, it's like recording canceled. Like, aw, come on. You really had to do this to me. I'm a guy who share plays. Let me share play. The whole game. Maybe next game, guys. Think about it. Yeah, anyway, I got bored here. But the true reason why I came here, you're probably wondering about the weapon proficiency. What I found, I hit my stats because usually the stats not important. But yeah, as you can see here, handguns, shotguns, SMGs, assault rifles, Gatling guns, launchers, and swords were the main thing I found out about. But yeah, for the shotguns, the SMGs, and the assault rifles, oh, and Gatling guns, I did not use this method. Also swords, because you'll see why later. The gun swords will work fine, sniper rifles work great, and launchers work great. But yeah, I had like launchers filled, so I shouldn't be talking about that. Yeah, the other ones I mentioned, the shotguns, SMGs, and the assault rifles, and Gatling guns, I just got that when I was trying to get this game platinumed. And by the time this video goes up, it's still not platinum. It's close. Only need like a couple more trophies, but yeah. Anyway, as for most people, you probably saw this method. The Subway A method, where you go to Subway A on expert mode and go and attack the boss there. And keep bouncing up and down, up and down, up and down. I had a full team of four just because I got late, because I didn't feel like changing it. Because I'm kind of on a time crunch. As some of you know from my previous videos, I talk about how I have two jobs. 7 days. A full-time job during the 5 weekdays, and then weekend job for part-time. Yeah, I tried to check the stats here, but I got a little lazy and forgot about I was in maps. But yeah, you see blasting away, using the upgraded version of the quiet. You see just keep blasting away, shooting at him, switching my swords. As you tell, this is kind of a good reason why not to use this method, because the only way to get, like, the stuff for the gun sword is just to have like some kind of fast shooting gun on them, but you can't customize those guns. Which is sad. That'd be kind of sweet, but I'm pretty sure there'd be a lot of people running with a fucking lightning or a high power handgun. But yeah, I checked my stats there, and then I checked again because I was using the sniper rifles, and it didn't go up at all, as you probably noticed. So I was like, oh yeah, screw this method. I don't know if they patched it or not, but yeah. Method doesn't work anymore. Then I went here, but not this method. Also, doesn't work only just for the weapon proficiency. It also works for getting some XP and a little extra bonus cash. A little extra, not a lot. But as you can notice here, I am shooting these guys just because I can. I would usually quickly polish these guys off, but I'm not using like a launcher or that. And yeah, as you saw earlier, I'm level 119 when I'm posting this video. When I started this, I do believe I was just about 100. And me trying to get you see here, just shooting away. And this is a lot easier. As long as you go for the Queen Wasp, it's easy. And I missed there. What's happening? I was like, oh yeah, swords are all filled out. I don't have to worry about full pelt strike getting in my way. I can use Dual Orbiter. Get muscle. But yeah. These guys actually give out pretty good drops, reward drops, and XP. It's not the best, but it's still pretty good. I mean, if you're on lower levels, I'd recommend trying this. If you're on lower level, try this. It might actually work out for you. I'm not trying to clickbait this at all. I'm like, oh yeah, do this. This is the best shit. Painful shit. No. I try to be honest. That's what I'm trying to do. Trying to get info out there for, and also trying to get people to laugh. That's some of the stuff I do. But yeah, this is literally pretty easy. I mean, all you have to do is kill the three Watts. I mean, yes, I'm commenting through the whole thing, but gotta keep you guys entertained somehow. I mean, I can't put music here because I don't know what's copyrighted or not. But you guys, you can just look that up, right? Yeah, but tight schedule. I literally record only, I record some videos, like, literally before I go to work, and then other videos legit when I get home. This is pretty much the when I get home situation. So yeah, I'm recording this on Friday the 13th. This is gonna be fun. Quote unquote rumors. Yeah, literally the gunblade though I found would be a lot easier than just the regular swords. For this, that's why I never use swords on this. But yeah, I mean seriously, try this out. It actually works. Just in the solitary sands, you see, just follow the dark trail on your minimap from the start. Just walk up the mountain. I mean, seriously, it's that easy. And then you just run back and forth until you get overweight. And you just shoot the hell out of everything. But yeah, this is where the, when I say overweight, that's where the whole thing comes in. About me not liking this game, and also when you know, maybe I should go back and sell some stuff. Because literally when you have that pop up, you just slow, and I hate that. I hated that a lot in this game. But I'm kind of a pack rat, so kind of teach me a lesson. But yeah, you see we're back here, and then these guys are going to spawn in 3, 2, 1. There we go. And they just use this just because the, you know, whole sword thing is not really the greatest thing to use. While fighting air enemies. Trust me, I tried. Yeah, this method actually works really great, and also, as long as you get the whole 500,000 for the bounty, total bounty you get when you kill enemies, collect rewards, kill unique enemies, I mean, this is a really good payoff. Some people may not agree with me, and some people think I've been talking too long. But I'm trying to get some stuff out here for you guys, for info. I know this game is kind of dead. Not kind of dead, pretty dead, but I actually enjoy this game a lot more than others think. Even though some people think this is a crappy shithole. Trust me, I have found some fun in this game. I do enjoy playing Sword games. But yeah, that's pretty much it. That's the end of this video and the end of this little tips and tricks for you. Anyway, I hope you really find this helpful for you. And this is the Cowbell, signing out.